This video we are making on the life of American blacksmith John Deere. John Deere was an American blacksmith and manufacturer who founded Deere & Company, one of the world's largest and leading agricultural and construction equipment manufacturers. Born in Rutland, Vermont, Deere moved to Illinois and invented the first commercially successful steel plow in 1837. This invention made him a big name and he kept climbing the stairs of progress. John Deere was born on February 7, 1804 in Rutland, Vermont. In 1821, at the age of 17, after a brief educational period at Middlebury College, he was understood to work with the Captain Benjamin Lawrence, a successful Middlebury blacksmith. He began an apprenticeship with them and entered business for himself in 1826 at the age of 22. He was married with Demarius Lamb in 1827 and gave birth to 9 children. Deere operated in Burlington before opening his own shops, first in Vergennes and then in Leicester. John Deere settled in Grand Detour, Illinois. At the time, Deere did not have much difficulty finding work due to the lack of blacksmiths working in the area of Grand Detour. Deere built a plow for the farmers there, but his cast iron plow did not work very well because of the hard, clayey, and chalky soil of Illinois. After changing many methods and changing decisions, an incident in Rutland was remembered in his mind. There was his father's tailoring shop. He grew up there. He saw and knew his father's work. He was done sharp and polished the tip of the needles by running them through sand so that it would penetrate easily into the fabric. And the work was easily possible. This incident led Deere to the conclusion that a plow made of highly polished steel and a properly sized moldboard would be better able to handle the prairie soil conditions, especially its sticky clay. Then he made steel plow instead of iron and polished it well. But he was not able to satisfy the Deere. Different versions of them serve as the inspiration for Deere's famous steel plow. In one version, he remembered the way polished steel pitchfork tines move through grass and mud, and thought a similar effect could be achieved for a plow. Another version is that he used an old saw that had been polished by years of use. In 1827, Deere developed and manufactured the first commercially successful cast steel plow. The plow with a wrought iron frame had a portion of polished steel. This made it ideal for the tough soils of the Midwest and worked better than other plows. In early 1838, Deere completed his first steel plow and sold it to a local farmer, Lewis Crandall, who quickly publicized his success with Deere's plow. Later, 2 neighbors ordered Deere shortly after. By 1841, Deere was manufacturing 75 to 100 plows per year. In 1843, Deere partnered with Leonard Andrus to build more plows to meet demand, but the stubbornness of the two men strained the partnership. While Deere wanted to sell to customers outside the Grand Detour, Andrus opposed a proposed railroad through Grand Detour and Deere's distrust of Andrus' accounting practices. In 1848, Deere dissolved the partnership with Andrus and moved to Moline, Illinois, as the city was a transportation hub on the Mississippi River. By 1855, Deere's factory had sold over 10,000 such plows. It is known as the plow that broke the plains and is celebrated as a historical place marker in Vermont. Deere placed an emphasis on making high-quality equipment. He once said, "I will never put my name to a product that does not contain the best that is in me." After the Panic of 1857, as business recovered, Deere left day-to-day operations to his son Charles. In 1868, Deere established his business as Deere & Company. In later life, Deere focused much of his attention on civic and political affairs. He served as president of the National Bank of Moline, as director of the Moline Free Public Library, and was a trustee of the First Congregational Church. Deere also served as mayor of Moline for 2 years, but due to chest pains and dysentery, Deere declined to run for a second term. He died at home on May 17, 1886, at the age of 82.